Hi, Madeline here from Sonic Bloom with a new episode of With a Little Help from Max for Life. And this time we're going to look at a free Max for Life MIDI effect by Dennis DeSantis, who's responsible for writing the manual for Ableton Live for a long time, if not maybe since the very beginning. And who's also written the fantastic book called Making Music, which is about creative ideas when you feel stuck. And this Max for Life device fits perfectly into this. Let's go to the clip view. As you can see, not an exciting interface. So it's all about the functionality of the device. All right, so I've already prepared a MIDI clip with different variations in all kinds of manners, so I can show you what these device parameters do. And let's play this back. And so the first one we can use is rotate pitch. As you can see with the A4, it moves in position to the right. Now back to the left. Now to the right again. But the note length is taken over from the note of that original position. This one moves the note length forward or backward. This one, the velocity, or which ones are muted. And as you can hear, we are getting constant new variations this way. And then we can also rotate the probability. So this is the new chance setting in Live 11. Or velocity range, another feature new since Live 11. We could also rotate the release velocity, but I haven't set anything for this right now. Or also just the notes themselves. Yeah, and so this way we're getting constant new variations. And one thing we could do is we could duplicate the clip here. And then rotate various of the clip parameters. Another option would be to route the MIDI output into another MIDI track, and then this will allow us to record on the fly all the changes that we make with this Max for Life device. I already made a tutorial about this, which I will just link here in the top right corner. Yeah, I hope you found this helpful. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe, and I'll hopefully see you next time. Until then, bye!